Good day to you. In our previous class, we have discussed the role plays, pronunciations and conversations. And I also requested you to record your voice regarding a conversation or a role play. And I also asked you to record your speech on the topic, why to wear a mask. But I have received only one voice record, Nana, literally one. I am very disappointed with this. I want every one of you to respond. Please speak out. I want you to speak out. See, while learning a language, simply writing on a paper, simply taking down the notes can't help us to speak. When we are open, when we put out the thoughts, when we speak out what is on our mind, then only we can improve our speaking abilities. The main purpose of learning any language is to improve our speaking abilities. Okay, so these kind of exercises, practices helps us to improve our speaking skills. That is why I requested you children to record your speech. Let it be one line, no problem. Okay, there is no any rule that you should speak for 5 minutes, it should be a lengthy speech. No such things here, no such rules here. Any one single line spoken by you is more than enough, Nana. I just want to hear from you children. Please respond to what I ask you to do and try to record your answer and share me on my WhatsApp number. Okay, this is a request, Nana. Please do follow. This will help you a lot. You know what? If you know the complete language, if you can understand language and if you can write the language and if you cannot speak it, it is of no use, isn't it? You should speak the language that you know. That is why we are learning the language. Why are we learning English, Nana? You tell me, what is the purpose? What is the reason? It is only to speak, to communicate. Okay, how do you communicate with others? By writing. What is the main way of communication? How do you talk to people? You cannot write it on a paper and show them, right? You have to speak out. That is why I'm asking you. Okay, got it, children? Please try to speak out. Okay, no worries, Nana. Only one line is also more than enough. I'll be really very happy if you speak for 30 seconds. Okay, I request you once again, please record something regarding any topic, okay? It's your wish. You take your own topic and speak something about it and share it to me on my WhatsApp number, okay, children? So, let's start our class today. In our today's class, we'll do our listening part. What is it? Listening. Listening means, please lend your ears, children. You are supposed to listen to the lesson here. Okay. So, what is your part here? I speak, you listen. Okay. Open your textbooks and look into the page number 11. What is it? Page number 11. Listening. So, here we have a story to listen. And the name of the title of the story is An Unexpected Reward. What is it? An Unexpected Reward. An
the work of a farmer.
He plants edge. So please underline the word drag, children. Underline the word drag. What is the meaning of the word drag? Once again, I read this for you. The farmer had taken his rag shirt. Okay, rag shirt means used for a long time, which is torn out. Okay, so that is used for a long time. When do people use a same dress for a long time? You tell me. When they have no other options. Okay, when they have only one or two. Okay, the shirt is ragged, means torn. Okay, that is very old. Got it? So what might be the purpose behind that, children? Because the farmer is so very poor, he cannot afford to buy a new shirt. Okay, so he has his ragged shirt and worn out shoes. Underline that word, worn out. Worn out shoes. So worn out means used for a long time. Okay, so what happens if we use the same shoe for a long time? See, in the farms and fields, they wear shoes to protect their feet from the insects and snakes, of course, which roam on the land over there. Okay, that is why the farmer wears shoes. You may get the doubt that why is he needed shoe, a pair of shoe? Because there is a danger for them while roaming, while walking on the paths in the farms and fields. They, of course, we all know that there is a chance of snake bite. Okay, that is why they wear shoes to protect themselves from the snake bites. Okay, so this shoe is also worn out. It is torn. It has holes in it. Got it? So this farmer, on seeing this, Nana, we can find that this farmer is in very poor situation. Okay, so he has no money to buy a new pair of shoes and new shirt. That is why he is still using the ragged shirt and worn out shoes. So what is this farmer doing here? He picked up his ragged shirt and worn out shoes and placed it on the edge of the roadside. He placed it on the roadside. Okay. The boy felt he could play a little mischief. So this boy, on watching this farmer leaving his shirt and shoes on the edge of the road, this boy who is walking along with his grandfather decided to make fun of this farmer. Okay, so let us see what he is going to do here. He said to his granddad, "Grandpa, why don't we take the man's shoes and shirt and hide them behind the tree?" So this boy is asking his grandfather to make fun of the farmer. He just wanted to hide his things behind the tree. What happens if he hides the things, the shirt and the shoes of the farmer behind the tree? What happens, children? After coming back, and so he starts searching for it, right? See, if you find your things missing, let it be your book or your toy or your mobile phone or your pen or your car, anything that you love and anything that is useful to you, that you make use of it every day. Okay, well, how do you feel if you miss it? If you don't find the thing that you placed, it is not there, what happens? How do you feel? You feel troubled, right? So in the same way, this little boy who is walking the roadside wants to make fun of the farmer. Okay, he left his things there. So this boy is, he wanted to hide the things of the farmer, that is the shirt and the shoes, behind the tree, so that he thinks that this farmer gets worried about the things and he starts searching for the things all around. So he thought that he could enjoy that. The boy could enjoy that. Okay, so he is asking his grandfather's permission to do that. Let us see what happens now. When he finds them missing, he will be so angry and we'll have the fun of watching his expressions. So this boy is thinking that on finding the missing things, like on finding the missing of his shirt and shoes there, the boy is thinking that the farmer gets very angry and he wants to enjoy the expressions of the farmer. How do you behave when you are angry, children? So every person behaves in a different way when they are angry, right? So of course everyone gets angry and they behave in a different way when we are angry, okay? So I behave in a different way when I am angry, and you behave in a different way when you are angry. We express our anger in different ways. So this little boy wants to see the farmer angry and how he expresses his anger and make fun of that. Okay, that is the reason here. But the grandfather replied, "Grandson, never make fun of a farmer or hurt his heart." So this grandfather is requesting, is telling, is asking his grandson, the boy, to not to make fun of the farmer. Okay. So is that good, children, to make fun of the people around us? Is that good to make them feel angry? Is there any reason for this? Why is this little boy doing all this? Is there any particular reason, do you think? I think no. Just to make fun of others. Is that correct, children? Is that a polite way to make fun of others? No. The grandfather is telling here not to make fun of others, not to hurt their heart. Okay. Not to make them sorrow, not to make them feel sad. Okay, it is not good to hurt people without a reason. Of course, if we have reason also, it is not good to hurt people. We should not make someone cry. We should not put someone into trouble. That is not fair. That is not a good behavior. So the grandfather here is teaching his grandson the good behavior. He is asking him not to trouble the farmer by hiding his things. That is a shirt and shoes. Okay. The grandfather doesn't want his grandson to be impolite. Okay. So what happens here? If you just want to feel happy, then let's do this instead. Okay. So the grandfather is also giving his grandson an idea to make him happy. Let us see what is that idea. Take some coins and place them in each of the farmer's shoes. See what an idea it is. Really, it's really a good idea. The grandfather is asking this little boy to take some coins, that is money, okay, some rupees, coins, and put that into, place that into the shoes of the farmer. Then we'll hide behind the tree and see what happens. So this is the idea of the grandfather here. So he is asking his grandson to take some coins and put it into the shoes of the farmer, and they are ready to watch the expressions, the feelings, the reactions of the farmer standing behind the tree. Okay, let us see what happens now. The boy did as his grandfather told him. So this is a really very good boy. So he did what the grandfather asked him to do. After a little while, the farmer came for his clothes. So after completing his work on the farm, on the field, the farmer came back to take his clothes, take his things, that are clothes and shoes. He put on his ragged old shirt and his feet into his shoes. Okay, after returning from the farm, after completing his work, he picked his ragged shirt and put it on, and then he kept his feet into the shoes that he left there. Okay. He felt something hard inside. So as soon as he kept his feet into the shoes, how did he feel? He felt something odd, something hard inside the shoes. You know what, children? What do you do before, when you go out, you put on your shoes, right? What do you do before keeping your feet inside the shoe? Won't you reverse your shoe and see whether there are some insects inside it or not? So that is a good habit, children. Whenever you put on your shoes, you should tap your shoe on the floor. Okay, that is safe for you. This farmer did not there something hard inside the shoe. So annoyed, he took the shoes off to see what it was. So as soon as he felt something is in the shoe, he felt very worried. Annoyed means, underline the word annoyed. Annoyed means worried, tensed. Okay. So he wants to see what is inside the shoe. That is why what he did here, he took the shoes off. He removed the shoe. He took the shoe off to see what it was. They were coins. So what were inside the shoe, Nana? They were coins. So on seeing the coins, he was astonished. He was surprised, amazed. Okay. So how do you feel when you find coins on your desk or in your books? When you find a rupee or a currency in your classbooks or in your textbooks or while walking on the roads, how do you feel? So as this farmer in very poor condition, is very poor, he cannot afford to buy his a new shirt for him. That is why he is wearing the ragged one, the torn out one. Okay. So on finding this rupee, the coins, the money in his shoes, he felt very happy. He felt very astonished, amazed. Okay. So that feel of finding these coins in the shoes left him with happiness. He looked up at the sky and fell to his knees. So what he did? He looked up at the sky and he fell down on his knees with the happiness, with full of happiness, because he needed the money. He is in need of the money. So for his surprise, his shoes were filled with money. Okay. He did not know, he doesn't know who bought that money for him, but he is very happy with the coins he found in his shoes. Oh great God, you are so kind. When I needed money the most, you sent me this gift. So he believes that this money is sent to him. This money is kept in his shoes only by God. So he is thanking God for the surprise. So he is also mentioning here that he is in need of the money. He needed it. Okay. So when we find something, when we are in need of it, we feel really very happy. Okay. In the same way, the farmer is also feeling very, very happy on finding coins in his shoes. Thank you God, and thank you to whoever you made your messenger. He is also thanking God for sending the money, and he is also thanking the messenger. Messenger means the person in between the God and the people, the person. So who is the messenger here, children? Who kept the money here, who placed the money here into the shoes of the farmer? Who is it? It is nothing but a boy. So who is the messenger here? Boy. The boy is the messenger here. Then he walked home overjoyed. The boy felt proud and happy. His grandfather said, "Grandson, the path to your happiness is to make others happy." Underline this line, children. The path to happiness is to make others happy. See, everyone is happy here. Like the boy is happy on seeing the farmer happy. The grandfather is happy because his grandson listened to his word. And finally, the farmer is very happy because he found some money. He got some money that he is in need of. Right? So, here everything is happy here. What would have happened if that little boy had hide the things of farmer behind the tree? It would left him with anger and sorrow. But a happy ending is the needed one here, children. See, we should try making people happy for anyone, whatever it might be the reason. But we should try making people happy, right? So this is our listening part for today, children. We'll continue in our next class, okay, with the reading part, okay? So please, children, follow my instructions and please give me response. Respond to what I ask you to. Okay. So when I ask you to record your voice, please do that for me, children. If it gives you any trouble, then no worries. So if you are okay with it, please record your voice. A 13 seconds recording is also okay for me. Okay. I don't have any problem with that, but I want to really hear from you, children. Please do this for me. So taking off for today, and we'll meet you in our next class. Take care. Until then, don't forget to wear your mask, keep your hands clean, and maintain distance.